Oscar did help Zero Dark Thirty gain the top spot at the box office over the weekend, as the film scored 5 nominations and $24 million. A Haunted House scared up $18.8 million for second place, and Gangster Squad was third with $16.7 million. Last week's winner, Texas Chainsaw 3D, fell all the way to ninth. Mm. A Royal Affair is an involving, enveloping true story of Denmark in the 1700s and is beautifully shot and lush. The luminous Alicia Vikander captivates and commands every moment she's on the screen and turns in a performance that is intriguing and mesmerizing. While royal shenanigans don't usually turn out so great, this is a love story that ultimately changed a nation. It deserves its Oscar nomination. 4.5 stars out of 5. I'm not feeling quite the awards attention being given to Zero Dark Thirty. Don't get me wrong, it's very good, but it feels like the best ever episode of Law and Order, not an Oscar winner. Jessica Chastain delivers a superb, strong performance, but the film at times seems to want us to step back and examine ourselves and see how awful we are. There were times the movie didn't ring true, and indeed, it has been reported that it takes many liberties with the actual story. I, for the most part, liked it, but heap less than the highest praise on it. 4 stars out of 5. Gangster Squad seems almost comic at times. That is not a good thing. Is it a parody or just bad?
Probably bad.
I lean toward thinking it's just gleeful in its excess. There's a lot of things to like. Emma Stone and Ryan Gosling both give pretty good performances. Sean Penn chews the scenery like never before, and his makeup is so bad it's distracting. There's plenty of action, so much it turns into a mindless shoot-em-up. Should have been a great movie, but it's not. Uneven direction and underwritten plot lines doom it to mediocrity. That's not to say it isn't fun. It's far from perfect, but I enjoyed it. 3.5 stars out of 5. Marlon Wayans takes on paranormal activity in A Haunted House. Like the films it parodies, it cost about $8 to make, and it shows. But Wayans is still Wayans, and this movie pours on the jokes fast and furious. So, most work, some don't, but for the most part, it's fun. If you've seen the movies it makes fun of, you'll like it. It's plenty stupid, but I did laugh. 3 stars out of 5.